Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be talking about the most important thing that beginners need to learn about SketchUp. All right, so I have a new file of SketchUp open here. I'm going to delete our scale figure and then hit R to make the, or to pull out the rectangle tool. I'm just going to really quickly draw a rectangle. Now, the important thing that I really want to drive home through this video is that SketchUp will make this a rectangle, but it's not actually a rectangle. It's made of four different line segments, and because those four line segments are on the same plane, it creates a face. So through this, you can delete, if you delete any one of those line segments, it will delete the entire face. That's pretty simple. Obviously, you know, if you're drawing in SketchUp and you draw three lines, anytime you draw three lines, as long as it's actually three lines, it's going to make a face, because that is those three points or three line segments are going to actually be on a plane no matter what direction. The other thing that I want to just sort of point out is that if you use a circle, so I hit C here to pull up the circle tool, in the bottom right you can see it says sides 24. Now, if I draw a circle here, it looks circular, but it's actually made up of 24 sides. So there's these little segments. When you're doing something in SketchUp, you can actually snap to those. It treats those as endpoints because they are endpoints. So actually in SketchUp, there's no such thing as an actual curve. Everything is made from different line segments. So this is really useful to know when you're modeling in SketchUp, because you can use that information to model things that are probably a little bit more complex if you were to think about them as being, you know, if this is a one-sided circle with a continuous line going all the way around versus a 26-sided circle. So basically what that means is I can take this line segment here and connect those, and it will make a face because I have my four different line segments that are all on the same plane. Conversely, let's say these aren't on the same plane. If I move this up and then try the same thing, just to illustrate that this isn't going to work, if I do that, it doesn't connect these, and that's because it doesn't recognize these as being on the same plane, no matter how I do it. So that's where the triangulation comes into play. So I've hit L here to make a line and then draw a line across. It recognizes, like I said before, that these three line segments can be on any plane that they want. There may be a kink here where it sort of just like isn't on the same plane, but that allows you to get the shapes that you want. And that's essentially how you can create everything. And maybe you don't want to see this line, so if you hit E, that'll bring up the eraser tool. And if you hold control and click on that line, it'll hide it. Conversely, what you can do instead of doing that, I just hit Control Z to undo that. If you click on the line, right click, you can go to hide and it'll do the same thing. And then if you want to see that, if you turn on, go to view, hidden geometry, you can see the little dash line there of that line. But when hidden geometry is turned off, it looks like just a single plane. So this concept of understanding that SketchUp is made up of a bunch of line segments, I think really simplifies everything when you start to think about that when you model. Because if you have really complex shapes, you know that you can sort of close them in using triangles. And by connecting the lines, you can really start to make the shapes that you are maybe having a hard time dealing with. For instance, if I have two arcs, let's say we have an arc here, right? So the arcs work the same way as a line. So it's given me, when I hit A, it gives me sides at the beginning. So I can essentially do any sort of shape here. So if I want to go in a different direction, let's say I choose this guy and this guy, and I'm going to go in the vertical axis. This shape here, this like little wedge shape, might be really hard to figure out how to do. And maybe you actually like want this to be curved or something like that. So if I take these, I can explode them for what I'm doing here. So I'm going to just select them and do explode curves. That's going to allow me to have both of these line segments. Now I can take and I can make these if I want this to be straight. I can do that. Now because this isn't planar, I'm getting that option where I can't. Now, because this isn't planar, it's not drawing a face there. So if I make an additional line here, it's going to allow me to do that. And then I can use that trick that we just did. So you can just go through essentially any shape or any lines here, and understanding that fundamental concept in SketchUp that everything is a line, and that by triangulating, you can make essentially anything in SketchUp. Will sort of unlock unlimited potential for you in this software. And that's really, I think, what I'm most excited about with new people in SketchUp, is just by understanding this simple concept, you can start to really do a lot of really creative things. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.